When I founded Yes She Can, I felt the most critical component was to actually have professional job coaches, people who had expertise in autism, who understood the underlying challenges of what people who had social and communication disorders were going through and what that would mean in a professional work environment, not just in school and not just out in the social world. So there could not have been a more perfect volunteer to help launch our program than Pat Rowan. Not only did Pat have the expertise in autism and experience particularly working with young women, but she also had a long career in business. She ran her own business with her husband, and so she understood what went on in the work world and what were the things that were challenging to people to be able to be successful at work. Pat helped define our program from the day one. We operated out of my home. Everybody starts an organization, you know, in their basement or in their garage. I started it in Izzy's family room. And she helped to recruit many of our trainees. And she also served as a volunteer job coach. She recently retired as a volunteer job coach, unfortunately for us. But we're still thrilled to have her as a board on our advisory board. So to share more about our first Advocates for Autism honoree, I'd like to welcome Westchester County Commissioner of Community Mental Health, Michael Orth, who's responsible for services for individuals and their families with mental health issues, developmental disabilities, intellectual disabilities, and substance abuse disorders. Please welcome Michael.
Deputy Commissioner Joe Glazer from our Department of Community Mental Health and I had the pleasure of visiting the store a few weeks ago, and we were able to witness firsthand the importance of the store, the professional support that was provided and skills, and the meaningful opportunities it provides so many young women, which is so essential in the work that we do. One of the things I think many of you know is that we need all of us to work together. And I also want to take this opportunity to thank all of you for your advocacy, all of your support. We have so many people in the room today that give endlessly to supporting individuals with autism and family members. And as a county executive, government has its role, but also the importance of non-for-profit community and family advocates. So on behalf of Department of Community Mental Health, we appreciate all you do. It is my pleasure to introduce Pat Rowan, a tireless champion in this field. As Marjorie said, after leaving the business field for 23 years, she got her degree in social work, which happens to be my profession as well, so I'm glad you joined us, after graduating from Hunter College. She has worn many hats over the past several years as a therapist, an advocate, a trainer, and also as a consultant. She served 6 years as director of the TEACH program, which serves students from K to 21 years of age in the Howland School in New Rochelle. After that, she went into private counseling, focusing on families, teens, and young adults, a critical population that we still have lots of work to do, which I'll talk about later. In that experience, she recognized the lack of opportunities for young adults to meet, socialize, and interact with each other. And that's still a gap, as I'm sure Pat will tell you. She created a program called Opening Doors, and it's a group that's been held ever since 2007 at Westchester ARC. And why this is so important is with all the traditional services that are available, it gives young people meaningful connections, a socialization opportunity, and to experience things together. In 2013, as Marjorie said, Pat joined as an advisor coach, and this is really critical. This is something when Joe and I went to visit the program. It's very organized. They use a curriculum, they use assessment tools that help these young women really challenge their strengths, look at areas to focus on, and lead to meaningful experiences even beyond the store and their experience there. And we saw it happen firsthand right in front of us in working with the young ladies. Pat was also one of the founders and members of our Westchester Autism Advisory Council, which was formed under former County Executive Spano back in 2008. And they released a report in 2009 outlining some areas of focus, some recommendations to the County Executive at the time. And Leslie Gatton and Judy Overman were chairs back then. And as the County Executive said, it's 10 years since that report was released. Our next advisory meeting, which will be held in April, we're going to kind of dust up that report and see what have we done, what have we accomplished, but also looking at some of the gaps. And as many of you know, there's still a long way to go. There are areas that we need to build on. So I'm asking all the advocates, all of our members, to really look at, again, celebrating success is important, but also being honest and recognizing other steps that we still need to take. So it sort of inspired us to recharge and to revisit so many of the things that are so important. And I think opportunities like this are critical in supporting our young people. I asked some of her colleagues and friends to share a little bit about Pat and how they described her. And there were some consistent points that Pat is rock steady, she's strategic, she's a solid clinician, she's a team player and a collaborator, and most importantly, she's passionate about helping others. Pretty strong words from your colleagues and people who've worked with you. So it is my privilege, it's my honor, to ask Pat to receive this most deserving award, and thank you for all you've done for so many families, so many young people in Westchester County. Pat?
Oh, I'm humbled by that introduction, and I'm humbled by the appearance of all of you and your warm and open-heartedness and generosity today. It's a program that deserves your generosity, but we don't always get it, so thank you. Okay. It all started with a devoted, prescient mom who had an idea, and a little girl diagnosed with autism with a love of American Girl dolls. Marjorie Matfis knew that because of her different abilities, Isabel would not have the skills and opportunities to move forward in her adult life without specialized training. I remember vividly the day Marjorie announced this idea to the Autism Advisory Committee. Many were skeptical. This was an unproven paradigm with many hurdles to get over and issues to resolve. I had had years of experience working with young adults on the spectrum, and I witnessed their struggle for independence and the uphill climb to find their first job. I knew that Girl Again had so much potential to meet this need and was inspired to immediately volunteer to help make this idea a reality. First, we needed to create a safe and nurturing environment for our young women to harness their strengths, learn job skills, but also to gain an appreciation for business in general and the bigger picture in a work setting. The training environment we created is safe and nurturing with supports that meet the unique needs of our young ladies. Our trainees needed to not only learn job skills, but also to tap deep into themselves, transcend their fears about what they can do and not do, succeed or fail, but at least keep trying, so that they could one day offer the job market the best of themselves and become gainfully employed. Developing this program would take time and many iterations, but I never doubted for one moment that it would succeed. The Girl Again program has generated the enthusiasm and talents of many of you sitting in this audience today. And I would like to take a moment to extend the honor that I am receiving to all of you. Leslie, Jen, Teresa, Chandra, Fran, Sherry, and Diane. You brought not just superb clinical talent, others' organizational and business skills, but most importantly, open hearts and minds. You were ready to take on an unproven paradigm and carefully craft it with your talents, devotion, and persistence to create the program we have today. Thanks to all of your efforts, we now have proof that this program works. The Girl Again team has developed a viable assessment tool, transferable to other settings, giving us real data validating its efficacy. Further evidence of the training program's viability is the fact that our young ladies are now being hired by open-hearted companies like Clarfeld, who are willing to focus on their strengths and allow them to enter the job market with the supports they need to be successful. Today, I would like to honor the young women trainees, many of them sitting in this room today, as well as our graduates who have moved on to be gainfully employed. I want to thank you trainees, all you young ladies, for your trust in me. You have motivated me, inspired me, and taught me so much. Before I end, I would like to speak for a moment about the importance of volunteering. This is a choice you make that can create an opportunity to change people's lives, including your own. A dear friend and colleague who's not here today, Susan Cordelette Jones, ends her correspondence with this quote. quote, service to others is the rent you pay for your room here on earth, unquote, Muhammad Ali. Thank you, Marjorie, for your vision of Yes, She Can, Girl Again, for the honor bestowed on me today, and for giving me the opportunity to be part of something greater than myself. Thank you to my colleagues for your support, your wisdom and dedication, and most of all, your friendship. And to my husband and family and friends who are like family and you know who you are, thank you for putting aside your busy schedules to come here today. With your love and support, you complete me.
I have the honor and privilege to give Pat her award. Pat and I have crossed paths for, I don't know, 15, 20 years. She is a friend, a mentor, somebody that I look up to, someone whose commitment I appreciate, and I'm so happy to be here and honored to be able to give this to you.
Thank you.
Yeah.